attention, please. We are about to begin the remarks, which will take the form of a question and answer between myself and Donald Trump, and Victor Pinchuk will introduce Mr. Trump.
Donald, do you hear us? Donald?
I hear you beautifully, oh, Victor.
Super, thank
beautifully.
You. Glad to see you. It was nice to see you in New York.
I hear you, Victor.
Super. Great that you are together with us tonight. It was nice to see you in New York. And we are here, we are really follow your election. And for us, it was extremely important and interesting to listen what you said about importance of support of Ukraine. And that's why it was our idea, it was our dream to convince you to deliver, to tell something about your position, about your opinion. And thank you very much that you are here tonight with us. And I just wanted to ask Douglas Sean, my friend and advisor.
Thank you very much, Victor.
Thank you, Donald. To be moderator of this extremely interesting discussion. Thank you very much. I wish you all really interesting conversation. And Douglas and Donald, floor is yours.
Well, thank you very much, Doug. And, you know, you have a wonderful person in Doug, and Victor I've known for a long time. And he is a tremendous guy. Tremendous guy. So it's a great honor to be with everybody. My feeling toward the Ukraine and the entire area is very, very strong. I know many people that live in the Ukraine. They're friends of mine. They're fantastic people. Victor is an example. Victor, by the way, is a very, very special man, a special entrepreneur. And when he was up seeing me, I said, I think I can learn more from you than you can learn from me. My feeling is that with respect to the Ukraine, people have to band together from other parts of Europe to help. I don't think that the Ukraine is given the proper respect from other parts of Europe. And this is a respect that the Ukraine deserves, and they've proven this over the years, over many years, but it's a respect that they absolutely deserve. So whether it's Germany or other of the countries, I don't think that you're getting the support that you need. The United States has been supportive, but more verbally than anything else. Our president is not strong, and he is not doing what he should be doing for the Ukraine. So far, we have all lip service, and in this country, we call it just that. It's lip service and nothing else. Part of the problem that Ukraine has with the United States is that Putin does not respect our president whatsoever. It cut off.
Donald, your last comment was that Putin does not respect our president.
Yes, now it's back.
Good. If you could elaborate on that point and on your vision for our foreign policy with Ukraine, that would be, and indeed okay. the world, that would be very useful. And you need not wait for any translation. Okay.
Okay. Putin does not respect our president, and, you know, it's just one of those things where it's just not happening, and we're talking about many, many different elements, but it is a big problem. And it's a problem that is taking place all over the world with respect to the United States. There's a lack of respect for our president, and there's a lack of respect for the government itself. So this is something that really you have a problem, but many other countries have a problem, and frankly, the United States itself has a problem.
Donald, another question on that theme, the role of U.S. leadership in the world, the role of the U.S. president in providing leadership. Could you speak about how you would approach those subjects?
Well, the United States is an amazing place. It's got tremendous potential with the right leadership. And right now, obviously, that leadership doesn't exist, but has tremendous potential as a world source and as a world, you could almost say, I want to be a cheerleader for the world. I want the world to be a safer place. You look at what's going on right now in the world and throughout the world, there's conflict everywhere, whether it's the Middle East, you look at Ukraine. I mean, you're in one of the great examples of all time. Look what's happening with Ukraine, with Russia. There's no respect for the United States. If I win, there will be great respect for the United States. They will respect us. And again, we will make statements, and I think those statements will be honored. The fact is that Ukraine is an amazing place. You know, I've known so many people, so many years in the Ukraine. These are people that want what's good, they want what's right, and they're not being treated right by the United States. And also, by the way, and I hate to say this, they're not being treated right by Europe itself. They're not being treated right.
Donald, one question on the economy. The role of the president as an economic leader, obviously your business success is extraordinary. How would you be effectively an economic ambassador, an advocate for American business, both here in Ukraine and around the world?
Well, I love the idea of free trade, Doug, and I think it's a great thing, and I'm a free trader and I believe in it. The problem is that we don't really have good free trade because the United States is a country that's being taken advantage of by almost everybody. We don't have good trade deals. And one of the reasons we have so much money going out, one of the reasons we owe $19 trillion, which is an unthinkable number, and by the way, it's a number that's going out, it's going up and going up rapidly, is because of the fact we have such bad trade and trading policies. We should be taking money in. We're losing our jobs. We're losing money and income. We're losing our base. We're losing manufacturing so much, and it's going to lots of other countries. I will be able to change that. I'll be able to change it quickly. We will not be taken advantage of, and countries like the Ukraine that need help will be there to help them. And we just think there's great spirit. I will say this. I've been watching the news. I've been reading so much about Ukraine over the last 6 months to a year. It's amazing what you've had to endure. You've endured a tremendous amount. And I just think it's all going to work out well in the future for the Ukraine. The people are tremendous. The spirit of the Ukrainian people is absolutely incredible. The Ukrainian people are special people. One of the reasons I'm even doing this right now is I know so many people that live in the Ukraine. They're incredible people with incredible spirit and incredible heart. So I think it's going to work out well ultimately for the Ukraine. I do think the United States should be somewhat more proactive. I think that Europe has to get very much more involved.
Donald, one final question on an issue that we are doing, indeed related issues, which is the role of global terror, ISIS, the migration crisis. What would you say about those issues and our role?
Well, the migration problem is such a horrible thing on a humanitarian basis. When you look at what's going on with the thousands and tens of thousands and probably ultimately millions of people flowing all over Europe and flowing through Europe. And some countries have really opened up and they've done a beautiful job. You look at what Germany's done. They have really done — maybe they haven't been of such great help to the Ukraine like they should be, frankly, but they certainly have been much more open-minded and open-hearted as far as the migration is concerned.